our topic was proctoring as a layer in XBlock framework. So what we need to do was, proctoring means invigilating. So we need to actually make an application, invigilating application, and make it in such a way so that it can actually act as a layer in any XBlock. So we can actually integrate it any XBlock, that is, I mean, in any course. So he's Hemant Katari from NIT Silchar. I am Pranav Dikshit from IITSM Dhanbad. He is Siva Donkada from IIIT Nuzul. So our objective was to create an application so that it can help teachers in proctoring the online application similar to what we do in offline examinations. But it will be automatic and it will require no manual intervention. Secondly, we have to create a web restriction application that will actually put some navigational hindrances to the student so that he cannot cheat by, I mean, managing the web browser things. I mean. So purpose, as I told, as in offline exams, we have to make an application that can work similar to that way. And secondly, the XBlock should be integratable with any edX course because, I mean, it should act as a layer so that we can actually integrate it into any exam. But we will actually prefer if it will be added into timed exam because, I mean, in untimed exam, there is, I mean, it can work, but problem is we have to, I mean, spend more on hardware. So for saving images and data, that's one. For third, I mean, teacher would be provided with appropriate proofs so that in future, if he is asked by student that why was I marked as cheater, so he can actually have proofs, appropriate proofs for reference. So, and also he can actually, I mean, determine the accuracy of the application if he thinks so. So he can actually look at the most suspicious one, students, and he can actually see their suspicious images.
Coming to activities which are considered as the suspicious, according to our system, the first one is impersonation. So impersonation means if some other person writes the exam who is not enrolled in the course. The second one is rotating your head in left and right direction above certain amount of optimal range, because a student can move his head in left like this and keep some material here and he can copy from there and he can write exam. So we are considered that as a cheating. And third one is coming to this is a web restriction one. So any act of these four things, first thing is minimize browser window. So why we are considering this as minimize cheating? Because he can minimize the browser window and he can go his own material and he can copy. So second one is migrate into other applications similar to like that, but he can move to any applications there in his system and he can copy. And third one is opening new tab or new incognito tab, because he can open new tab and googling some answers and he can copy from there. The fourth one is resizing browser window. So he can copy by resizing window and he can place some material in another window and he can copy from there. So we consider these as a cheating according to our system.
Also, we will actually maintain appropriate proofs and appropriate
can
timings.
Can I open another browser?
No, sir.
Taking a cheating?
Yeah.
Because you said open new tab, new incognito tab.
If you will go out of browser exam window, you are marked as cheater. I mean, the time will start, that only.
And what proof are you giving for all these acts of cheating?
Okay, so I mean, for web images, we would be, I mean, showing some model boxes. We are not showing alert because some student may actually click on prevent page from creating additional dialogues and then he won't be shown alerts. So we are actually showing him model boxes that cannot be, I mean, prevented by page because these are just banners type of thing. So we will be, I mean, when...
What proof are you giving to the teacher?
Yeah, so I mean, when he will be doing some suspicious act related to browser restriction, that model box we will save. In that model box, we will have username of that student, the time at which he did cheating, and what type of cheating he did. So we will be actually saving that screenshot into the suspicious image folder. There are two types of folders, suspicious image and web image.
We are giving images to images as a future reference for teachers.
So this is admin view. So we will be creating a course in which we would actually load our XBlock. So I mean the point is actually we are actually alerting the teacher if he is actually adding it to untimed exam. There is a reason to it because I mean teacher might unknowingly add it to some untimed exam. So first we would be actually comparing his image from the stored image, the image right now, to catch any impersonation instances. So he would be taking his snapshot, he would be submitting it. I mean this is the view for, I mean, what from outside, so that we can see if he's cheating or not. I mean, this is not actually in that. We are actually showing it for the reference of them.
These looking there and you're showing front face?
No, he is actually looking in front only. He is actually providing his image.
It's a text snapshot, no?
Yeah, he is taking a snapshot by clicking here.
Sorry, but that time you're looking there.
No, this is actually, I mean, we have taken from another laptop. That is actually telling.
This is the test image. Currently, when he starts taking, he is starting taking it.
No, this is not test image. This is actually, I mean, we are actually storing. This thing is another browser window. This
we are editing the video here. Laptop.
So we are actually showing because when he would be cheating.
Student, when I say text message.
No, this is not appeared for the student.
This is not actually student.
Actually, we are intending to see show this because the student is writing exam here and this video is taken from another laptop and we will. This is the live.
This will not be here. We are just showing it so that I mean you can see that if he is looking away at that time when we are marking at his cheating instance. That only.
Okay.
That is for comparison thing. So his image will be compared.
Take a snapshot or not?
Yeah. So I mean, at that time it will show this model box. Okay. Then go ahead.
Means actually user tries to open new window by pressing Ctrl N. So he is.
First, have you started the exam?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
To start doing.
Okay.
Whatever activity, all cheating you do, and show me my teacher. That's all I want.
So we are actually saving it in a manner that first there would be course name, directory name, I mean name of directory would be course, then the block name, block ID, that would be I am storing it in the server in a directory. That path would be specified by admin. Okay. So first we will be seeing web images. So it is actually storing time, username, and that what activity he did that was marked as suspicious.
On 5th July at that time, user Siva as a user. Yeah. He has done that, he is pressing Ctrl and all things to open new window by pressing Ctrl and. So we have stored it as a cheating.
This is
the screenshot for
okay.
Future reference.
Now for that suspicious image thing, okay, go ahead.
And
all
web images, okay, fine.
And
this is another one when he was minimizing it, right? So I mean we have actually carried all tests, so this is the second one. Go ahead.
And he is moving to some other.
This is the third one. That
resizing.
He has actually tried to resize the window. We have actually incremented a counter, incremented some time. So actually, this is also storing. We are.
Please resize the browser window to original size.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I need a corresponding message that you have not resized the window, or you have resized the window to your size.
Yeah. So what we are doing actually is that we will actually. We are not expecting him to start from that full browser window. Okay. So we are actually storing the time. It was not of full browser window. That only.
Arre, I am just looking at it from a teacher's point
okay.
of view.
Okay.
So you are giving me all this message. At the end of this message, I want to know whether he is actually resized or not.
So that you will get from overall time he was, doing something suspicious. So something suspicious means.
Where is your user manual for that? What are the things I have to see? You built a system,
just,
right?
Yeah, just a okay. MySQL
for
table.
Which you are saying that my requirement is that I will tell this teacher. Okay.
Yeah.
Correct.
Yeah.
So you are showing me what is stored to the teacher.
Yeah.
Now you are also telling me teacher has to do that thing. Teacher has to do that thing.
Yeah, that will come later.
Where is it stored? I will do it. But
okay, that will come later, na? That
we are showing. So show me everything.
Okay. So these are the suspicious images that we took. Okay. Go ahead.
No, I mujhe nahi samjha. Ye kya hai?
I mean,
go back. A little bit.
This is web image.
Oh, Siva web image.
Yeah.
Huh.
Another is susp image. Susp underscore.
Oh, Siva susp image.
Yeah. That will be have suspicious image.
Correct.
Okay. Go down. Go ahead. So these are the suspicious images that we found while he was looking away. So I mean, he looked away in the middle of that. Right. Okay. Go ahead.
Siva directory mein kya hai? Usme kya hai?
Yeah. This thing. So compare images.
There is web image. There is susp image. Compare image, I am not worried.
JSON underscore data will show if the user actually started his webcam or not, because that is a possible thing that he will have no suspicious images if he didn't even started his webcam, right? If he didn't started his webcam on Firefox or any browser, then there will be no suspicious images. So we are actually storing
right,
that.
Okay,
also.
Done. So I have seen that this is how you store.
Yeah.
Abhi, now give me the view what the teacher will see in OpenADX.
So this will be update suspicious result. So actually there would be some due time then at when after which the student cannot give the result, I mean exam. So teacher would, whenever he wants to see the result, he will first click on update suspicious results. It would actually, create a total count variable that will actually, store web.
So that's what the teacher will see.
Yeah.
Here I will see Siva.
No.
Dikhao.
This will update it. Then when you will click save student's name. Right now when we did it, we had just one user, rest of all were none. But this would actually save a TXT file.
Where will I see whatever you showed me?
In a TXT. Yeah. So in when you
either video or regular. Tum dikhaoge nahi to mujhe kaise samjhega?
So save student names on clicking.
Show me that Siva. Whatever you have stored in that directory, show it to me.
Okay. You think that is not in this because there was single user.
So.
So I mean.
Single user ne ye kiya
to. Single user can be done, but I thought that I mean it is not. If we do it, there would I mean just one single name in that TXT file.
Show it to me in video. Are you saying you are not going to demo what the teacher sees in your?
Just that TXT file is not there because there was single user.
But okay, forget it. You are not ready to demo.
Yeah.
You are going to show me a video.
Yeah.
So in the video, show me how the teacher sees the result. No, in the video, the teacher's view. You are not even showing me video.
The suspicious images are done. That's a thing. But
that is done in the disk, yaar. Teacher, you expect the teacher to go on the server disk and look.
So, actually that thing only we tried to make a front end for it for creating students. We actually were not able to integrate it into this XBlock. That's what limitation. Achha, of
so you have not done it.
Yeah, future
so
scope
have
I have actually added
scope.
Into this.
We have done all thing but we have not prepared
that
a front end for the teacher
problems,
and we tried it and this is we mentioned it as a future scope. We have done all things
that
and we are not giving
scope.
A front
no,
end that's all.
That is not future scope.
We actually tried to integrate it, but actually, I mean, there were some problems. We were not
correct. So it is definitely not future scope.
Yeah, it is. It can
even
be done.
Team
finally,
which has actually implemented, created a directory
yeah.
structure, created everything.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and after that, a team is not able to integrate. How anybody else will be able to integrate?
Actually, I mean, there is just one single thing: a HTML file we have written, but we are actually not able to integrate it into this thing. I mean, that is actually totally independent of this whole system
okay.
application.
Okay,
so,
forget it. You are
yeah.
not able to integrate.
Yeah, that's fine.
Tell me the requirements.
Requirements?
Requirements. What you are trying to do?
Okay, what we were
it's
trying to do?
Requirement
yeah,
nahi hai.
We have. So what we were trying to do was we will actually create an application that will actually I mean teacher that will actually store all the images and suspicious images or whatever so that teacher actually can refer it later at the some directory that will be specified
refer
by
refer nahi later it has to be inside open edx only
okay so what we are
okay nahi is it inside open edx
open
only?
Edx
open edx
not another application
not another
so it's inside open edx
yeah.
okay so the where the there will be a button.
Yeah,
right.
There would be
so
one.
When he presses the button, what he is supposed to get?
Okay, so when he will press that save student's name, that will actually tell him.
I will not get any student name.
No,
when
I'm,
you press
I'm telling it. So on clicking that, he will get in the manner of descending order the student's name who did the most number of suspicious things. Okay, when he will click, on, I mean he would mostly be concerned about the person who did the most amount of suspicious things during exam.
Why others? I will say okay.
No,
I
am
actually. 1000 रुपए का चोरी ठीक है, 1000 रुपए का चोरी कोई वही करेगा क्या है?
I am actually telling. I mean, I have to give some order, na? This order is actually
so
the most
fine.
Logical one, right?
So you have done something.
Yeah.
So he is supposed to get the most order.
And then we
then
were.
Then what he is supposed to
so
do?
So then we were actually trying to, I mean, add a hyperlink.
अरे बाबा requirement बोलो.
Yeah. So I mean, this thing was not in there. So we were just trying to do that. We will actually store it somewhere in that directory. Okay. Then when he will click on that student, he will get all images related to that student.
That's
all.
On clicking the
no,
button.
And
kya?
That's it. I mean, he will actually then see the images if the system performed.
I mean, what
it.
Do I do? I like this tool. अरे अच्छा है. Left hand face से right hand face से ज़्यादा अच्छा लगता है.
No.
ऐसा बोलना है मैंने.
Actually.
What is my decision?
For example, I mean there is I mean because this system is not actually accurate, not perfectly accurate, right?
Correct.
So I mean there may be some instances in which he will be looking straight, but those would be marked as suspicious, right?
I don't care. What do you expect the teacher to do?
So I mean,
first of all, if I have got like 5,000 students and all of them take that,
yeah,
okay, I will have most probably I will have all 5,000 lists, okay.
5,000.
Every all 5,000 you are going to mark as suspicious because you are not taking any decision. Okay.
Yeah.
So you have marked all 5,000. So I have to physically go and look at 5,000. फिर उसका mug देखना है. फिर क्या करना है तुम बोलते ही नहीं हो.
So point is, I mean, this
decision
we have to left it to teacher, na? We cannot actually, I mean. Do anything just depending on
teacher what I said what
teacher will look at the images he will see
that okay that
yeah.
you are showing me what
so,
I will do after looking at
yeah
the images.
That so I mean he will see maybe there is a chance that application didn't perform as it was expected so there would be some images in which he was looking straight but they were marked as suspicious So in that case, he will say no, this person was not actually suspicious, application didn't perform
say
well.
Say, Moose, you have got a recording think, device, I don't understand.
I mean,
is
he will...
Are you giving voice commands to teacher? Yes, this is okay. Not okay, aisa command hai kya? What is your software allowing him to do?
Listen only, he will get the proofs, he will get the proofs of suspicious images, then everything is left to teacher. That
after
is up to teacher.
Looking at the proof.
That is up to teacher now. I mean, we.
Up to teacher meaning what? Jump up and down, go to sleep, aisa karna hai. What do you expect him to do? Where is the documentation?
There is nothing now. If faculty wants to withhold the certificate, that is
between
him
and the system manager. If teacher confirm the student is cheating, then he will not give certificate to that student. Up to that.
What nonsense is this?
Yeah, that we are
where
doing.
Where is that log? He is not providing any log.
So we are actually, I mean.
I write it down by hand. Other suspicious hai, power suspicious hai.
So only those students name would come na, those were marked as suspicious. That
so
only.
What is your system? I have definitely have a problem with you are showing, okay, the box. Okay.
Hmm.
So what do you mean? I have to look at all the boxes. Kya likha hai usme? What is the suspicious thing? Are you look left? Acha, you look right.
So best way to, I mean, avoid that is not do cheating. That's it. I mean, if you
won't do cheating. No, I'm not cheating.
Yeah,
I don't. That is your rule. Left ko kya cheating hai.
We are not going to show in that case. We are not going to push, I mean,
notification. No, wait. What I'm saying is, you know what action has prompted that thing.
Right.
Correct?
In browser.
Now, correct. You know that.
Yeah.
But you refuse to tell me that. You will show me a big screen. I have to look at it and find out what is the message. I don't understand that thing at all. You have tried to open the browser. Oh, message aya. I will not tell the teacher that he has attempted to open the browser. I will show the message. So teacher has to read. Why?
No.
That is actually future reference only.
Are I understand. That is the proof.
Right.
But I am supposed to look at the proof.
No. He web image thing is actually accurate. There won't be any. I mean,
but what he has done, I have to look at. No other way, how will I know? That's why I asked you what the teacher sees.
He just sees he did something suspicious related to web image. That's
that did something suspicious. I have to go and look at that image and read it. No. Well, you know that he has tried to open a browser.
No, we are actually giving the most suspicious students' names, and.
Are yes, you are okay. All the students have tried to open a browser.
Okay.
What I will say, 5,000 students, ye open karo, message, open a browser. Second student, open a browser. Third student, resize. Aise ke teacher ko kaam danda nahi hai, when
sir,
you know what he has done.
So cheating by doing resizing and cheating by opening a new
but
tab.
But Baba, this knowledge you know. So why can't you say ki this student tried to resize the window 5 times? No, but they have again the same problem. They have not looked at. No. Sorry. What the teacher will see is inside their scope. Okay.
Yeah.
But their design is not correct. They have not looked at it from the teacher's viewpoint. This whole system of capturing a web image instead of capturing the event is wrong. You know the event.
Hmm.
We have prompted the message.
Hmm.
You will not count the number of events.
We are counting now. Web underscore image in database. That's how we are actually calculating total underscore count.
The image is actually
capturing that.
Yeah, so I mean.
You show me web underscore
open
image.
Open the database.
Correct.
This is here. So web underscore count would mean how many seconds he was away from our window, or how many times he actually tried to do something like resize, or I mean press control alt.
Yeah, but this is not sufficient. Again. Web underscore count doesn't tell me resize kitne baar kiya hai, naya window kitne baar khola hai, that it doesn't say.
So cheating in any way is cheating na sir?
Cheating
no. As a teacher I will say I don't mind resize. It's my job, no. That's what I said. What are you allowing the teacher to do? That was my question.
We are not allowing to him to.
Correct.
We are
so, and you are not giving him all the information.
We are giving just the global value, I mean for final.
Correct.
Value.
You are not
right.
Giving all the information.
Right.
And if I have to go and look at how. 35 times kya kiya hai, I have to see 35 images. When you know for sure there is 10 times web resize and 15 times that. So that information is lost.
So we can give, but we are not giving.
Correct, correct. That's okay. That doesn't matter. You are not looked at it completely. Okay. And you are not presenting the result of the thing properly.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah. Fine.
You are not looked at it from the teacher's viewpoint.
Trying to give front
end. Trying to look, I understand. You have gone half the way. Yes. So now you have captured as how many images are there. Okay. Okay. But in a real system, okay, the presentation is going to be an issue. Okay. Correct. Okay. Suppose I see that, I find ki baba, these people have captured left and right. Pahla student left right mein bola theek hai. Second student left right mein bola theek hai. Okay. Now I have no means of, I have come to the decision ki ये इतना सब कैप्चर करता है कि लेफ्ट राइट इज प्रॉब्ली आई ऑलवेज से ओके व्हाई हैव टू गो एंड डू इट फॉर 100 स्टूडेंट्स ओके दैट इज माय इशू
एक्चुअली वी आर स्टोरिंग
द रीजन व्हाई यू आर शोइंग इट टू द टीचर इज टू मेक अ डिसीजन ना यू आर नॉट अलाउइंग हिम टू मेक अ
ओके आई मीन टेबल्स इनटू डेटाबेस कैन बी एडेड फॉर डूइंग दैट बट आई मीन वी हैवंट डन दैट
यू नॉट अलाउड हिम टू मेक अ डिसीजन
फाइन
Okay.
Yeah.
The decision you are saying is case by case.
Okay.
You are making an assumption that the number
all
of people will be
cheating,
very
yeah.
less.
Yeah.
That is not likely.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Because you may be wrong. That is why you are giving it to the teacher, and you are not allowing a teacher to act properly. Okay. Yeah.
All right. Quick question.
Okay. Very quick. Okay. So, if there are lots of mosquitoes in my room and I start looking here and there, what happens to your system? Okay.
We are actually, I mean, then you have to actually tell the teacher that there were many mosquitoes and
fine,
I was looking.
So, another question. Okay, so there is a better way of doing it rather than with just images. So, you can actually summarize a video. You take the whole one hour video, use the computing power of the local machine.
Just a minute.
Yeah. And then you send only a summarized video which is only 2 MB or 3 MB. And that will actually tell you whether what the person was doing.
So, I mean, this application that I actually implemented.
Rather than image, because image does not tell you many things.
Yeah, I mean,
it just
for example.
Looking this side or here.
Okay.
Correct. No, your JavaScript can. You are still capturing an image. So, you can capture a video.
So, we can actually show the video too.
Like this, but it will be overload the server.
No, you summarize this video. You don't see once you have a whole video or even any differences that is seen in the video, you capture and that is accumulated and stored as a video.
Sir, then video has to be sent to server. Then
server.
It loads a server.
You are anyway sending images.
But sir, actually,
so
I mean,
at the
sending
of
images.
The end of the exam, you send that video.
So I mean that would actually, I mean at the end of the exam the load on the server would, I mean definitely increase then, no? Because
So wait after another 5 minutes and then send. So you can always design it.
And then actually, I mean hardware constraints are there.
As Aparna said, they had a charter to not load the server.
Right.
No, that's okay. I mean so. Did you find that server is getting loaded?
Yeah, I mean even when we are actually taking images right now, actually I mean just to make the system more accurate, we are actually taking images at an interval of 2 seconds, right? So in 2 seconds, I simulated it for 30 users.
So
we actually did the
1 hour exam. How many images?
For 20 minutes, we actually carried. I mean because other people have to test it also. It may have over. So there were 18,000 images. And they actually took about 3.24 GB.
I'm not debating with you.
No, yeah,
I'm
actually telling the results.
Look at an alternative which is available and look
video.
It for yourself whether it is going to be useful. I mean video summarization. If it is not useful, don't use it.
By summarization means compressing and saving it like
you
that.
Don't compress a video. You only take those portions of the video which is going to be useful for you. That's it.
Portions of video instead of frames.
Yes,
combination
if
of frames.
If user is not doing any activity other than just typing, you don't take that video.
Yeah.
You take only that video which is you are interested.
Yeah, that is
in.
I mean definitely.
So interesting
okay,
events
yeah,
you
yeah,
capture.
Fine. Okay, fine.
And you.
I mean in the place when I am actually capturing frames
with you, okay.
Yeah, yeah. I mean in the place when I am capturing
fine.
Frames, we will actually record a video and then we'll send the segments to the server at the end.
Yes. That can be done. Figure out how to do that.